Hello everyone. In today's video, we are going to discuss again about interviews questions that are asked from engineers from their interviewer. Okay, so in our last video, we have discussed about interview questions. So today I'm going through more interview questions. So let's start with our first question. The question name is, what is a virtual LAN? This is the important question, and most of the companies ask these questions at very first place. Virtual LAN is known as VLAN. Okay, so basically VLAN is used to break, it is used to break the broadcast domain of a switch. Broadcast domain on a switch, on a network you can say. Okay, like for example, you have a switch. Switch is connected with 5 to 6 PCs, and all the PCs have same network IDs. And you know that if you are using any IP address range, for example 192.168.1.0/24, so it has one network ID 1.0, 1.12.1.254 are the host IDs, and 192.168.1.255 is broadcast ID. So if I am pinging from my first PC to my last PC, then they will broadcast. Now what is the role of VLAN is, if you divide these three PCs, like these three switch ports in another VLAN number, and these three PCs are in another VLAN number. So what will happen? The broadcast domain of the switch will break into two parts. If you ping from this PC to broadcast ID, then only two PC will reply. And if you ping from this PC, then these two PCs will reply. Like this setup is used in companies. For example, if you want to break the broadcast domain between HR department, in networking department, or marketing department, or technical department. Like you don't want that HR people can connect to my networking people directly. So you can use this concept VLAN, and VLAN is a numbered range from 1 to 1005, in which VLAN number 1, 1002, 3, 4, and 5, these are the by default VLANs, and you can 2 to 1001 VLANs can be created. Okay, so in our next topic, we have to discuss about what is spanning tree protocol. Like what is STP? So STP is also a layer 2 protocol, like we have discussed VTP in last videos. Spanning tree protocol is by default enabled on every switch. Why? Because it is used to avoid the loop between redundant link between switches. Okay, like for example, the one PC connected to this switch, one PC connected to this switch. If we have used multiple link between the switches, then by default, if one port switches are green, then on another switch, one port will be green and one port will be blocked due to STP. Why? Because if this PC send message from this port to this port, and the same message can be transferred to this switch again. So if all the ports are open, then there will be a loop. So to prevent the loop, we have used spanning tree protocol with the election of root bridge and non-root bridge. Root bridge is the switch which has lowest MAC address and bridge ID, and non-root bridge is the highest switch with great MAC address. Okay, root bridge ports are always green and non-root switches ports are green, but they are in the form of root port. So STP is used to break the loop, and it provides the data transfer from one switch to another switch. The another question is, what is convergence in routing protocol? Okay, in every routing protocol, we have a concept of convergence. Now, what is convergence? Convergence is the time actually taken by the router. Okay. For example, from one path, one router to another router or another destination, we have multiple paths like this. This is my destination, this is my source. So you can go via this, this and this path, multiple paths. Now what is convergence? So by default, router has one best route. For example, I'm just taking an example. This is my primary route. Okay. When my primary path goes down due to any condition, when my primary path goes down, then router takes some time to find the secondary path. Like this router will take or choose the path from these two paths. Then at that time, it will take some time interval. Okay, when my primary path goes down, router takes some time to find the secondary path. That time period is known as convergence. Okay, so convergence is the important factor in routing protocol. And another question is, why we use nowadays OSPF over RIP? So we can say OSPF is open shortest path first and RIP is routing information protocol. Okay, the main difference between OSPF and RIP is that RIP is a distance vector protocol and OSPF is link state protocol. And the metric of OSPF is, metric is the criteria to find the best route, cost, like based reciprocal of bandwidth. But RIP's metric is hop count. Even your paths are from fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, 10 gigabit Ethernet, RIP always choose path based on hop count, but OSPF choose path based on bandwidth. And the important difference to choose OSPF over RIP is, in OSPF you can use unlimited hops, like unlimited hops of your router. But in RIP, maximum 15 hops are used. If you are using 16 or 17 hops to reach the destination, it will not work. That's why we use OSPF over RIP. We have another so many differences, like you can say OSPF use like a fast timing and RIP use less timing, like we have discussed about convergence. OSPF convergence is very fast, RIP convergence is very slow. OSPF timers are only 2, hello and dead timers. RIP timers are 4, update, invalid, hold down and flush. So that's why we are using OSPF over RIP. So our last question is, what is NAT? NAT stands for Network Address Translation. Network Address Translation is also a security concept like ACL. But in ACL we use blocking. In NAT we use to like hide our internal IP address space from outsiders. Like NAT is used to hide internal private IP address space from outsiders. Like for example, this router is connected with one network and this address range is 192.168.1.0/24. Now any hacker or outsider can do spoofing attack on your router, so automatically he will know that your, what is your range, because we have so many tools nowadays. So if we implement NAT on this router, then this IP address range is changed into any public IP address space that you can purchase IP address from ISP. So when this address range is changed into, for example, 200.0.0.0.0.1.0.0.2.0.0.3, then your network will be safe, because when it replied to outsider, then it's sending its identity by faking. Okay, so address will be changed and the other person who is going to trap your network, he will not be happy. Okay, so these are the some interview questions. So in our next video, we will discuss about more questions. Thank you.